Sweet violets, sweeter than all the roses, covered from head to toe with sweet violets. Guess what we're going to talk about today? If you guessed violets, you've got it right. Welcome to my 60th video here on EatTheWeeds.com with Green Deane. So let's go talk about violets.
I wanted to give you a close-up view of the plant before we went out in the field because particularly the blossom is kind of hard to see out there. If you notice, it's got five petals and it's unevenly distributed. The middle petal on the bottom has also got some stripes on it, and the leaves are, in this particular species, are heart-shaped and very succulent and shiny.
Well, I found myself a little patch of violets here and some here. Ignore the mushrooms, there's some here. There's even one growing over here, and then there's some right here, and also over in the bush here. So we have a little patch of them growing here, and they have to be pretty happy. So let's talk about the violets. My first recollection of violets is my mother going out behind the house in the springtime and eating them. She used to call them Johnny Jump-Ups. First, to make sure, we're talking about the Viola family, violets, not about African violets at all. Not about African violets, but violets, the Violas. Violet leaves have a wide variety of shapes. These happen to be close to heart shape, but they can also be round and oval. They can be bird foot even shaped. There is a bird foot violet. As far as edibility, you can eat them raw, or you can pick them and cook them like spinach. Nice patch here. I believe these are Viola sororia, which means sisters of violets. Now we'll take a look at a blossom. Got one right here, matter of fact. See if we can pick it up. Violets come in a wide variety of colors, from white to light blue to blue to yellow, and bicolored as well. They're all edible, except you should remember that the yellow violets in large quantities can be laxative. Violets were among the first, if not the first, commercial flower products. Way back in 400 BC, the Athenians were raising them. That's about the time Socrates was around and also the Acropolis was being built. Violets have a long history. Look at that pretty flower right there. These happen to be light blue. When the Emperor Nero died, somebody planted violets on his grave. And in Paris, when Chopin died, his student bought all the violets in Paris and put them on his grave. And to this day, people put violets on Chopin's grave. And before the 1930s, violets were the preferred flower to give to on Valentine's Day. And interestingly, the Indians, Native Americans, there's no record of them eating the violets. They use the violets for medicinal purposes, such as externally and internally, and there's a lot of applications there. But there's no record of them actually ever eating them, though we presume they did. Informally, there are two large groups of violets. There are the sweet violets, which are nicely scented and aromatic, and that's what the Romans loved to make their wine out of. As a matter of fact, the Romans liked their violet wine so much, they even ignored growing olives for a while. Horace chastised them for that. And the other group is called your wood violets. They tend to be larger, with less scent or no scent. By the way, pansies are violets, and you can eat pansies, but don't eat commercial pansies. Those have had growth hormones and pesticides and stuff like that put on them, so you don't want to eat those. Only eat pansies that you raise yourself. And I want to remind you before we go on, I'm not talking about African violets. No, we're not talking about African violets here. I'm talking about Viola violets. Here in Eat the Weeds, we itemize, so let's itemize the violet. We start with identification. Five petal flowers, yeah, five, and they're irregular, meaning they're not always shaped exactly the same. But the lower petal always has veins on it, and they're usually colored. And it goes back into a spur. The side petals can have little hairs on them, usually, but not always. And the blossoms can be blue, white, yellow, or multicolored. Stems can be long or short, and they kind of like to grow in clumps. The leaves are a variety of shape, from heart shape to bird foot shape, so there's anything in between. Time of year. springtime into summer, or in warmer climates, also in the fall. Environment. They like it more wet than dry. They like damp woods, moist meadows, things of that nature. They're a plant that really likes the moisture. Oh, and also, dappled sun. You won't find them growing in full sun usually. They do well with shade. Method of preparation. Leaves raw or boiled like a spinach. Blossoms raw or candied. And my mother used to eat stems right off the plant. Kind of like a deer she was, out there grazing. Violets are a delightful little flower, but I want to remind you, if your patch is small, don't eat them all. Leave a few for the woodland creatures. So thank you for joining me here on my 60th video on EatTheWeeds.com. If you want to know more about violets or other plants that are edible, go to EatTheWeeds.com and you'll find about 175 other plants there. So until next time, this is Green Deane. I want you to think green. I want you to eat green, and sometimes that includes blue, white, and yellow, and multicolored violets. Sweet violets. And have a good New Year.